Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. We are going to start with a series of videos in which I'll be talking mainly about the topic, as you can see here, enzymes. So I'll be talking mostly about enzymes in my like 3 to 4 videos. Let us dive into the channel, let us dive into the video. If you are watching or coming, you visited to my video for the first time, hit the like button. If you like the video, subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon also so that you'll be notified for the upcoming videos. So, enzymes are biocatalysts. What are biocatalysts? Catalysts which are present in living organisms or living beings is called as biocatalyst. Enzymes are nothing but these are biomolecules. Okay, so this leads to our next point. Almost all enzymes are protein, but all proteins are not enzymes. Here, if I'll explain you the point, almost all enzymes are proteins. Means what? For example, I take an enzyme, say I've taken the example of sucrase. This is an enzyme. Okay, this is a protein. But if I take example as keratin, which is a hair protein, it is a protein, but it is not an enzyme. Okay, sucrase is an enzyme and is a protein. Keratin is a protein, but it is not an enzyme. Okay. Next point, some enzymes are nucleic acids called as ribozymes. So what is the meaning of this? Nucleic acids, we know it can be either DNA or RNA. DNA, deoxyribonucleic acid, RNA, ribonucleic acid. Okay, so I take, for example, I've got an RNA molecule. RNA molecule acting as an enzyme is called as ribozyme. Okay, so if I have, say, 10 enzyme molecules present in it, a 10 enzyme molecule group, for example, 9 enzyme are going to be protein, 1 enzyme is going to be ribozyme. That is the reason why we are saying almost all the enzymes are proteins. Let us move on to the examples now. Here I've got sucrose. What is sucrose? The sugar that we put in our tea or in milk and then we drink it. So sucrose, if I want to break the sucrose, I take an enzyme called a sucrase. And then, as it is a biocatalyst, it will either speed up the reaction or it will speed down the reaction. Okay. For example, you people might be driving motorcycles or vehicles. The accelerator which is there is used to accelerate as well as decelerate. Okay. So, catalysts are nothing but molecules that increase the reaction rate or decrease the reaction rate. Okay. So that means it the enzymes alter reaction rate. I want to here increase the speed of breakdown of sucrose. I use an enzyme called a sucrase, giving me glucose plus fructose. So this sucrose is a disaccharide. It has got 2 units into it. I break the bond, I get glucose and I get fructose. Okay. Next example of enzyme is maltase. Here you can say see this maltase is used for breaking down maltose into glucose plus glucose. Again, maltose is a disaccharide and I am using an enzyme to break this. I want to speed up the breakdown. I use an enzyme called as maltase, then I end up getting glucose and glucose. So this was a brief introduction about enzymes. In the next video I'll be talking more about the enzymes. So if you like the video, hit the like button, share it with your friends and then subscribe to my channel, hit the bell icon also so that you'll be notified for my upcoming videos. Thanks for watching, thanks once again, and then meet you in the next video. Bye bye, take care, see ya.